Hi, Jim Kelly from Hunter Lomison here, and we're here to talk to you today a little bit about generator maintenance. If you so desire and you want to do maintenance on your generator, we have kits available for that. Today we're going to talk about the 22, and its kit number is 0J93230ESV. The kit comes with a funnel, two spark plugs, a label to label last time you serviced your generator, an oil filter, an air filter, and a paper towel to clean things off. It also comes with a set of instructions on how to follow and how to do this operation. Today what we're going to do is, the first thing we're going to do is start and run the generator. We're going to take the front off the generator so we can see everything, see what's going on. We're going to start and run the generator for 5 minutes. What that does is allow the oil to get hot and make it flow better out into the oil receptacle. After 5 minutes, we shut the generator off. Take the little cover off the control panel. We pull the fuse out of the control panel, and this disables the generator so we can work on it. At this point, we take a proper oil receptacle, put it in front of the generator, remove the cover, we take the oil drain hose out of the receptacle, remove the little cap on top of the hose. Let the oil drain for several minutes into the receptacle. When the oil stops flowing, put the cap back on, hose back in the receptacle, and the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take a piece of cardboard, we're going to shape it in the form of a V, put it underneath the oil filter, remove the oil filter, and let the oil drain into the receptacle. What that does is keep the oil from getting onto the base of the unit. When that's done, remove the paper or the cardboard, take a rag and wipe around the base housing of the oil filter housing. Take a new oil filter that was in the kit and take a little 5W30 synthetic oil and put around the base gasket of the oil filter. At this point, after you clean the oil filter housing, screw on the new oil filter onto the unit and make it tight. At this point, we're going to take our paper funnel and remove the cap on the valve cover, put the funnel in, and we're going to pour 1.9 quarts of oil into the engine, 5W30 synthetic oil. For the single cylinder units, we're going to put 1.7 quarts of oil into the engine. Remove the paper funnel. Place the cap back on the unit. At this point, we're going to talk about replacing the spark plugs. Remove the spark plug wire from the front. Take a 5/8 deep well socket and remove the front spark plug, and there's one in the back, and we'll talk about that later. Just talk about the front for right now. You take your plugs, and they need to be gapped to 30 thousandths for the 8, the 11, the 20 and 22 kW generators. Whereas the 16, they need to be gapped at 40 thousandths. After they're gapped, install the plugs back into the unit, tighten them down, install the spark plug wire back on the unit, and the same operation gets done in the back. At this point, we're good to go on that. Next thing we're going to tackle is going to be the air filter. At this point, we're going to take and unlock the cover, remove the top cover from the air filter, remove the air filter element, dispose of it, take a rag, and clean the inside of the air filter housing and around the base of the oil air filter. Reinstall the air filter back onto the engine, place the cover back on, and secure it with the lock. At this point, we're going to take our fuse. We install our fuse back into the engine, into the control panel. At this point, we're ready to start the engine. I want you to start and run the engine for several minutes. By doing this, you get the oil to flow through the engine, get it through the oil filter and the engine, and check for leaks. You don't want any leaks. Make sure that's good. Shut the engine down. At this point, you want to take the dipstick, pull the dipstick out, check the level, make sure it's correct. You might have to add a little bit, so hope you save the funnel in case we have to add any. Put the dipstick back in, check it again if everything's fine. At this point, we're done, we're good to go. Put your front cover back on, put your top cover back down. Also, one thing I gotta remind everybody is place the unit back in auto. Once we're done with all these operations, you gotta make sure it's in auto so that it's ready for your next outage. At that point, close the cover, lock it if you feel necessary, you're good to go. Thank you very much. This is Jim Kelly from Hunter Lomison. If you have any questions, give us a call.